Hello, I show you the left corner parsing, and this kind of left corner parsing can't cope with empty productions or with left recursion. Here you see the definitions of the rules we can apply, and they may look a little bit scary, but please bear with me. I will guide you carefully through them, because in an exam you are might allowed to use definitions, but you may have not my videos at hand, so I will teach you how to read them. Here you have the parse tree of the whole word, it's for orientation. And here is a chart that we will fill out now. So let's begin. If the chart is empty, the only rules we can apply is the ones that don't have any antecedent items. So that is this rule, it's called axiom. And we don't need any items to apply that rule. And what we can do is, it says we have to put the input string in the left column, in the left stack column. So this will be my idea. I shall write the input string into that column. So in this case, it's ACB. I'm supposed to write the S symbol, the start symbol, into the middle column. And I shall write an epsilon or an empty symbol into the right column. And the operation, of course, is the same name as the rule, so it's axiom. And what does it mean? Well, it's in the left column, there we have the symbols that we have completely seen. So you can say, in this case, you see it's the input symbol, so we have that given, so we have definitely seen the input. And it's, maybe you can imagine it as something that comes from below. Then here we have the non-terminals that we have predicted, and that we are that we have not seen yet, but we try to see them. So maybe you can say it's something. Well, we will put a lot of the right-hand side's rule on it, so it's maybe like something that comes from the right. And on this stack, there we have the left-hand sides of the rule that we want to see, so you can say that something that comes from above, so to give you a rough idea of what the stacks mean, but it will be clearer in the further parsing process. So now let's see which rules we can apply. We have the rule move. This is one we can apply if we have a dollar symbol on the middle stack and we don't have it, so we can't apply that rule. Here's the remove rule. We can apply it if we have the same symbol on top of the left and on the middle stacks, which we don't have here, so we can't apply the remove rule. So we are only left with the reduce rule. And what it says is, if on top of our stack, on the first stack, in this case x1, there is a left corner of a rule, then we can remove that symbol and put all the rest of the rule onto our stacks that we want to see. And the symbol we have there, the left-hand side of the rule, we put in our stack of the left-hand sides. And that's what we are doing now. So let's see what we have here. So we need a symbol on our left stack, on our completed stack, which is the left corner of a rule. So on this stack we have an A. And let's see where it's the left corner of a rule, and it's this rule. So then first let me do this step first. So here on the left stack we have the left corner of the rule, and here it's away, so we will just copy what was there before. So we will keep C and B, and the operation is, well, I said we will reduce with A expands to A. So, now let's see on the middle stack there we have where there will be something that's just copied here, so we will keep the S. We will put a dollar symbol in front of it. And then here we will put all the part that's behind the first corner of the rule. So in this case, well, you see behind the A there's nothing, so we just have, well, something like epsilon, but we don't really put anything here except the dollar symbol. So, well, we don't put anything here. And on the right stack, we will keep whatever is there and we put the left-hand side on top on it. So in this case, it's our A. And here we had nothing, so we will just be left with the A on our stack. So, and what you see now is we have a dollar symbol on top of the stack. And that means that we have seen the full right-hand side of a rule. And, well, as you saw before, we had A expands to A. We already have seen the A and there's nothing left behind the terminal A to see. So we have indeed seen the full right-hand side of a rule and we are left with a dollar symbol on the stack. That means we can apply the move rule. So I will just say move and it's move on the previous item, on the previous chart item. And what it says, well, I have, let me put the ID here first. What it says is here we have a stack symbol that we will just leave here, but we will put the symbol on the right stack in front of it. So here we have the A. In this case, it's our A, and I will put it in front of the stack of the things we have already seen, because we have seen the whole right-hand side of the rule. That means we have seen the left-hand side of the rule. So, and we will keep the CB there. We will remove the dollar symbol, so we are left with the S on the middle stack. And on the right stack there we will just, well, it's what's left when we take the A away. So we are left with the epsilon. So what's the next thing we can do? Well, we don't have another dollar symbol on the middle stack and we don't have the same symbols on our remove stack. So the only thing we can do now is to reduce further. And to give you now an impression of what we've seen, well, we have seen the ACB input, and then we have seen the complete, we have predicted the A, and we have seen the complete A rule. So that's what we have seen now. And what we had is we predicted the S, that is something from above. And now what we are doing, what we want to do now, is we want to reduce with those S expands to ASB rule. So we want to apply, the only thing we can do now is to use the reduce rule one more time. That means we are looking at our first stack and we want to find a rule where this is the left corner of the right hand side. And the only rule is that one. So we will again apply the reduce rule. We will remove the whatever is the left corner. In this case, it's our A. We are reducing with the rule S expands to ASB. So A is our left corner. In this case here, it's blue. Now it's the other rule. So in this case, A is the blue symbol and we will take it away. Here we are left with CB. On the right stack, we will put the left-hand side of our rule. In this case, it's the S. And on the middle stack, we will keep what we had there before. We will write a dollar sign in front of it. And then we are putting everything that's right of the left corner. So the left corner was our A, and what's right of the A is S and B. So we are putting S and B onto the stack. Now what we can do next. So well, that's what we now did here. We had those S, we connected it with the A, with our ASB rule, and now S and B are waiting to be completed as well. And well, the S is waiting because we didn't have seen all its children. So what's the next thing we can do? We can, well, we don't have a dollar symbol on the middle stack. We don't have the same symbols on the, like we need for the remove rule. So we are applying the reduce rule one more time. So we are looking for a rule where C is the left corner. And the only rule this which applies now is S expands to C. So we will reduce one more time. With S expands to C, we are taking the left corner away. We will put everything that's, well, we will keep everything that was here. We will put a dollar symbol in front of it, and we will put whatever is right of the left corner, but there isn't something, so we are left in this situation. And we are putting the left hand side of the rule, in this case S, on our stack of left hand sides. So now we have the dollar symbol on the middle stack. That means we can use the move rule. That means we have again seen the complete right hand side of the rule. So that means we can complete the left hand side as well. So we will get our new entry. We will move the symbol from the left hand side stack to our stack of completed symbols. So the S from here now moves to here. And we remove the dollar symbol from the middle stack, and we are left with everything that was behind it. Now we have the same symbol on the left and on the middle stack. That means we can use the remove rule. And before I forget, now we did the reduce of this part. So that's where we are left now. So now we can apply the remove rule. We can, if we have just the same stack symbol on the left and on the middle stack, we can just remove it. So in this case it's the S. And in this case it's the S. We can leave it away because what we have seen is the same as predicted. So we can just, we don't care about it anymore. It's like it's completed. And the right stack will just stay how it is. So that was remove of the S symbol. Well, and here it's where I forgot I forgot to write the operation. It was a move operation. Now I did the remove, and now we are. Well, as you see, we have the B here. We don't have a dollar symbol on the middle stack. We don't have same symbols on the other two stacks, so we can only use the reduce move rule next. So we look at the B. We look for a rule where this is the left corner, and that is this rule. So we will apply reduce once more with the rule B expands to B. That means we can take the left corner away. We will put our B onto our stack of left hand sides, and we will put onto our stack of on our prediction stack of of right hand sides, we will put a dollar symbol and whatever is right of the left corner, but there's nothing behind the left corner. So we are left with a dollar symbol on top of the middle stack, so we can apply the move rule once more. So we take the dollar symbol away. We move the B from the stack of left-hand sides to our stack of completed symbols. Now I have to scroll down a bit. But I think we don't need the axiom rule anyway anymore. But I may need a longer chart now. Then the next, we have the same symbol on the first and on the middle stack, so we can apply our remove rule. Oh, and where we went now, when we did the reduce from B to B, we just have seen this part. So now we can remove the B from the left stack and from the middle stack. Then we have the dollar symbol here, that means we can use the move rule. That means this S, that was the one in the middle, which we have now on it. No, maybe not. I think this was, this S was the one from the top. Now we have seen all the children of the top S, so we can use the move rule, move the S to our stack of things we have completed, removing the dollar symbol, and now we can apply the remove rule for the last time. We remove these two symbols from the stacks. And now there's nothing left to do, and we compare our last item with the goal item, which is a stack, which are three empty stacks, and where we are left now. And well, in the last remove and move steps, we have completely seen all our children of our S rule, so we have completed the parsing process, and our last chart item is the same as the goal item, and that means the parsing process was successful.